वेलकम, आई एम डॉक्टर सूर्यकांत तरतेन, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ शिवशंकर कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी नेरेसगांव। टुडे वी विल सी अबाउट डेवलपमेंट ऑफ वेल एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ वेल डेवलपमेंट एंड डिफरेंट मेथड्स ऑफ वेल डेवलपमेंट। द डेफिनेशन ऑफ वेल डेवलपमेंट इज द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ए ट्यूब वेल इन्वॉल्व रिमूवल ऑफ फाइनर मटेरियल फ्रॉम अराउंड द वेल स्क्रीन, देयर बाय एनलार्जिंग द पैसेज ऑफ passes in the water bearing formation to facilitate entry of water. Development increases the effective radius of the well and thereby its yield. There are different objectives of well development. The first objective is to correct any clogging of the water bearing formation due to fine material. The second objective is to increase the porosity and thereby permeability of the water bearing formation in the immediate vicinity of the well. The third objective is to stabilize the formation around the well screen so that the well will yield sand free water. In the process of development in a zone just outside the well screen, all particles smaller than the screen opening are removed, leaving only the coarser material in place. To remove organic and inorganic material which may inhibit effective well disinfection. Here in this figure, a gravel packed tube well showing the effect of development. Development removes the smaller particles and leaves the coarser material with increased hydraulic conductivity or porosity around the slotted pipe. In this figure at the center, you can see the slotted pipe in a tube well, and around the slotted pipe there is a uniform gravel material, and well development is carried out through this gravel pipe, gravel pack. The purpose is to remove the finer material or bridging action that is present in between the different gravel material. The purpose of well development is, of course, to increase the hydraulic conductivity or porosity or transmissibility in the immediate vicinity of the slotted pipe or well screen. Or the purpose is to increase the effective radius so the yield of the well will increase after well development. The basic principle in well development is to cause the reversal of flow through the screen opening that will rearrange formation particles. It is essential to break down the bridging of groups of particles. Here in this figure you can see bridging action caused by the arches of sand grains when the flow is in one direction only. And in case of well development, actually what happens, you can see here the bridging action. When the flow is takes place in reverse direction, this bridge can be broken down, and whatever the small particles are there, they may come inside the tube well, and by using different pumps, such particles can be withdrawn outside from the well. Above figure shows how small sand particles can reach large sand and gravel particles and well screen opening when the flow of water is in one direction only. The basic principle in well development is to cause the reversal of flow through the screen opening that will rearrange the formation particle. It is essential to break down the bridging of group of particles. Above figure shows how small particles can reach large sand and gravel particles and well screen opening when the flow of water is in one direction only. Reversing the direction of flow by surging, the well overcomes this tendency. The outflow portion of the surge cycle breaks down the bridging, and the inflow portion then moves the fine material towards the screen and into the well. Development should continue until the discharge water is clear and all fine material from the well and adjacent aquifer have been removed. The time required for development depends on the nature of the water bearing layer. the thickness of screen slot relative to aqueous particle size, the amount of material raised from well prior to placing the filter pack, and the type of equipment and degree of development desired. Large amount of development energy are required to remove drilling fluid containing clay additives. There are different methods of well development. Here you can see different methods. The commonly used methods of developing tube wells are: first one is overpumping with the help of pump. Second one is the surging with surge block and bailing. Third one is the surging and pumping with air compressor. Fourth one is the backwashing with pump proceeding under pressure with compressed air. The next one is the high velocity jetting. The sixth one is the fracturing, using blast enhanced pneumatic hydroliquefied carbon dioxide. And the last is the chemical treatment.